Hi, I am Pawan. I'll be teaching you science. Today, I'll be teaching you about 6th standard science, first lesson, our food. In the previous lecture, we have talked about different types of foods and ingredients used to prepare that foods and what are ingredients and sources of the ingredients. And we also made different tables, right? I gave you those tables as project work. And I hope you have done that. In the previous lecture, we have speculated different varieties of foods that your friends eat, your relatives eat, your parents eat. Okay. We also talked about different food items and the ingredients used in that food items. And I hope you have listed the ingredients used to prepare those food items. And also, we talked about the sources of the ingredients that we get the ingredients from different sources, and the sources like plants, animals and others, and the name of the plant and animal and others that we get ingredients from. Okay, children, the answers will also be displayed on the screen. You can see and you compare these with your answers and you just assess yourself as if you are right. If you have done these tables, I really appreciate you. And also, you will be given marks for your every work. Don't forget that. Now, you can give some examples for the sources of the ingredients that we get from. Here, for example, we get food from animals. We get food from animals and give examples for the animals. Can you give some examples of the foods that we get from animals? Yeah, we get food from animals like goat, sheep, hen, rooster. We get food from these, we get meat from these animals. You know, we get meat from these animals. We get meat from goat, sheep, hen, roosters, etc. And also, as far as this hen is considered, hen gives us meat and eggs as well. Okay, now let us talk about the examples for the foods that we get from plants. You know, we get food from animals and we get food from plants as well, right? Now, you give examples for the plants like leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetables like spinach, mint, coriander, etc. See, these are the foods that we get from plants. Now, you are maybe having doubt about the others. And where do we get some foods from other sources? What are other sources? For example, ingredient like salt. You know that salt is also an ingredient used in our daily food, daily menu? Yes. Salt we get from? Yes, that's right. We get salt from where? Water. We get salt from other source. Like salt, we get from water. See, the sources of ingredients, animals, plants and others, I said, right? We get food ingredients. Here, what should I write? We get food ingredients we get food ingredients from where? We get food ingredients from, we get food ingredients from animals, plants and other sources. You know, animal sources are these, plant sources are these, and other sources like water. We get food ingredients from animals, plants and other sources, right? And you just think about, if you are getting the food ingredient from animals, the food ingredient in the sense that we eat the flesh or meat of the animal, yes? And also, if you think about plants, we get food ingredients from plants, but only some part of the plants are used as food ingredients. Only some parts, you know, you can imagine that what parts of the plants are used as ingredients. You just think about, for examples, leafy vegetables, you know, the meaning in its name itself, you can understand that leaves are used as food ingredients. And if you take vegetables, and vegetables are the fruit of the plant. Vegetable, it's nothing but, it's like a fruit of a plant. And this is a part of the plant used as a food ingredient. If you take brinjal and if you take tomato, these are nothing but vegetables, but these are the part of the plant we use as food ingredients. And other parts, like, you know, that part of the plant that lie under the ground, that like, you know, potato, radish, carrot, etc. Other, you know, these are also used as food ingredients that are present under the ground. Even though they are the parts of the plant, they are also used as food ingredients in our daily menu. That's about that. And other than these, you know, animals and plants, other ingredients like salt, we have already discussed, right? We get it from sea. Salt we get from where? Sea. Other ingredient like salt we get from water, sea. Now, one thing that you have to understand, yeah, apart from this regular food ingredients and other food ingredients like dry fruits and condiments, you know, what are dry fruits and condiments? For example, if you are making a special food item on Sunday, so what type of special food item you prepare on Sunday? Biryani. Yes, everybody likes to eat biryani, right? In this biryani, what are the ingredients used to prepare biryani? We use fragrant materials like ilachi or cardamom, okay, and lavanga or clove, dalchini is cinnamon, and biryani leaves, you know, like bay leaves, we call that as bay leaves, and then so they are called as condiments. Condiments are the fragrant food materials. You can see the images of the condiments or fragrant food materials on the screen, they are displayed. Okay, now other food ingredients, like sometimes we use dry fruits as food ingredients. What are the dry fruits? Can you name them? Yeah, give some examples for the dry fruits. The dry fruits pictures are displayed on the screen. Cashew, almond, kishmish, pista. So these are the dry fruits that we usually use as food ingredients in some of the food items that we eat, like semya. If you are preparing semya or if you are preparing biryani, these are used. Some of these are used in semya also, and some of these are used in upma also, and some of these are used in biryani also. Cashew nuts, almond seeds, and then kishmish is nothing but dry grapes. Kishmish is nothing but dry grapes. Yeah. Condiments and dry fruits are not available in all the places. They are very expensive. So these crops are grown in some of the particular places in our country and in the geographical areas. Some of the particular geographical areas. They are available in less quantities and they are so expensive. That you just remember. Okay. Now let us talk about name of the plant and part of that plant that we use. Okay, you just do it as a project work. I'm just giving you the table that will be displayed on the screen. You just note the table in your notebook and write the part of the plant that we use as food ingredient. That I have already told you few of the food ingredients that we use from plants. Yes, like that. I hope you do this in your notebooks as a project work. What is the project work? Find the part of the plant that we use as food ingredients. Food, that's enough. Okay. Food. This is your homework and this is like a project work as well. This is for today and I hope you all understood this lecture and thank you for listening and thank you one and all.